The endocrine system is a series of glands that produce and secrete hormones that the body uses for a wide range of functions. The endocrine system works with the nervous system to provide homeostasis and balance in the internal environment of the body. So, what is the difference between the two systems? The nervous system will send signals to reach neurotransmitter at the synapses, which released and crossed the synaptic cleft to reach and act on the target cells. Now the endocrine system, on the other hand, will send signals not to get to neurotransmitters but through hormones. These hormones will travel via the bloodstream, where it will then target a cell and its specific receptors. So what happens with an endocrine cell is that when a stimulus or command comes, this will stimulate the endocrine cell to secrete hormones into the bloodstream. These hormones will then target and bind onto a specific receptor on a target cell. This will cause a target cell to initiate a long-term slow response. So the main difference between endocrine system and nervous system: the nervous system has short fast response, while the endocrine system has long slow response. But at the end the two systems complete each other to maintain homeostasis in the internal environment of the body. We should know that we have many hormones in the body that perform different functions or have different responses. Another terminology to learn is also what's called endocrine glands. Endocrine glands are essentially groups of endocrine cells that are dedicated to perform a specific function. So let's look at the first two or three most important endocrine glands. The first is situated in the brain here. This is known as the hypothalamus, and this is an endocrine tissue. The hypothalamus is responsible for the production of antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin. It is also responsible for the production of the regulatory hormones. Probably the most important endocrine glands are the pituitary glands, which are located right below the hypothalamus here. There are two lobes of the pituitary glands. There is the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. The posterior lobe secretes oxytocin and antidiuretic hormone that were produced by the hypothalamus. So the hypothalamus produces these hormones and sends them to the posterior lobe, which then the posterior lobe will secrete into the blood. The anterior lobe of the pituitary glands actually secrete many hormones, including ACTH, which stands for adrenocorticotropic hormone. TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, obviously stimulates the thyroid. The GH, growth hormone for growth. PRL, prolactin for milk production in the breast. FSH, which is follicle stimulating hormone. LH, luteinizing hormone, which are responsible for the reproductive system. So these hormones that are secreted by the anterior lobe, they are regulated by the hormones from the hypothalamus. So if you remember, the hypothalamus secretes regulatory hormones that regulates the secretion of the anterior hormones. There's another endocrine gland in the brain known as a pineal gland, which is around this area, and it secretes melatonin. Melatonin is actually responsible for the body biological clock. Now let's make our way down in the trachea or throat area. We have wrapping around the trachea. Here we have the thyroid gland. Now the thyroid gland secretes few hormones: thyroxine, which is abbreviated T4, and thyramine, which is T3. That's responsible for metabolism essentially. It also secretes calcitonin hormone, which reduces calcium level in blood. Now the thyroid gland, it also has another endocrine glands on it. So if we zoom into this area here, we're looking at this person from posterior point of view from the back. So we have the thyroid gland, and then we have these four sort of lobes on the thyroid gland. These are known as the parathyroid gland. So there are four parathyroid glands, and these are behind the thyroid gland, and they secrete the parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone is important in the regulation of calcium and phosphate in our blood in our body. It elevates calcium and phosphate opposite to the action of calcitonin secreted by thyroid gland. Now right below the thyroid gland we have another endocrine gland known as the thymus gland. Now the thymus is not really a big deal in the inner crisis, but it is a big deal in the immune system world. But in endocrine world the thymus actually undergoes atrophy during adulthood and it begins secreting thymosin hormone, which is important in maturation of T cells, white blood cells. Of course in this person we have the lungs connected to trachea and the heart between the levels. Now if you didn't know, the heart is also classified as an endocrine gland, because it secretes hormones, naturally peptide, which is responsible in blood pressure regulation. It actually decreases blood pressure when there is an increase in blood pressure. Digestive tract, they secrete a lot of variety of hormones, and what I mean by the digestive tract, I mean the stomach, the duodenum, the small intestines. They produce many hormones such as gastrin, somatostatin, cytokinin. Another very important endocrine gland or tissue, the pancreas. It secretes two main hormones, insulin and glucagon. Glucagon increases blood glucose levels. Insulin works opposite, it decreases blood glucose levels, and you might know diabetes. Diabetic people, they have very low insulin levels. Type 2 diabetes, they have low insulin levels. Type 1, they have depleted insulin levels. Kidneys also secrete hormones. They secrete erythropoietin, which stimulates red blood cells production in the bone marrow. The kidneys also have the very important adrenal glands. We have two adrenal glands, of course, because we have two kidneys. If we cut a cross section of the adrenal glands, we have the adrenal cortex, the outer part of the adrenal glands. And then we have the adrenal medulla, the middle of the adrenal glands. The adrenal cortex secretes cortisol and aldosterone and sex hormones till puberty. Cortisol is essentially for stress, and aldosterone is to promote sodium reabsorption as well as potassium secretion in the kidneys. And then we have the adrenal medulla, which secretes adrenaline and noradrenaline, also known as epinephrine or norepinephrine. These hormones are important in the fight or flight response as well as the rest and digest response. The last endocrine glands are gonads. Because we have a male and female version of humans, we have two types of gonads. We have the testes for the male and the ovaries for females. In the testes we have cells that secrete androgens such as testosterone, which is important for promoting male characteristics as well as sperm production. And then we have the ovaries for the female. We have important hormones being secreted such as estrogen and progesterone, which is important in female characteristics and egg production. Hormones are classified according to their chemical nature into steroid hormones and protein hormones. Steroid hormones made of fatty acids as adrenocortical hormones and sex hormones. Protein hormones made of amino acids such as insulin, thyroid, prostaglandin and cytokinin hormones. The endocrine system has a mechanism called negative feedback mechanism. In order to reach homeostasis in the body. To understand this mechanism, let's see this example. When the glucose level in the blood decreases below normal level, the hypothalamus secrete regulatory hormone which stimulate pancreas to secrete glucagon hormone. Glucagon stimulate liver to convert the stored glycogen into glucose. So the glucose level increase in blood till the normal. After that the hypothalamus stops secretion, which will stop secretion of glucagon hormone and stop the entire process.